Wherever you're watching from any part of the world, it is good to know that you are following our cultural trend. I am not the custodian, but I'm here, I'm standing, and I'm sitting on the rock of the custodian of African culture and heritage. And I wouldn't want to say further until I allow my host to introduce and to set the ball rolling. Kadisi, it is nice and good to meet with you. And I think the whole world is already in conversation with your action. Kadisi, you are one of the Kadisis that are on social media doing what? What are you doing here, sir?
Well, social media, first of all, is the thing. It is the quickest way to get to know everybody. And because everybody claims now that the world is a global village, there's no way I'm not going to be part of it. Not just me, but my community as well. So I'm glad to be on social media because it is a very small world. And we need to project what we are doing for our people, particularly those of them in the diaspora.
Thank you so much, Kabiesi. Now, you can see a nice intro. If I had told you that my Kabiesi is a social media Kabiesi, it could be like packaging. You heard from him from the intro. Kabiesi, can we start from knowing you? We want to know you. We want the whole world to know where we are. You know, I didn't say where we are. So we want the whole world to know where we are. Over to you, sir.
Are you ready? Are you sure you're ready?
Yes, sir.
We thank God. First of all, we need to thank God for your saving our life. We've been following the successes of heritage. And we're particularly happy to be associated with it. And most welcome to the Osusa Kingdom.
Thank you, sir.
The Luo Moruyo, the Luo Gunde, the Luo Begonde, the Siwuji. I always like to hide the fact that it is the town of Leto Batugunde. Because Ogunde brought Osusa into the international limelight long ago. As the doyen of Nigerian Theater has, it is easier for anybody in the whole world to know and to know the town you are talking about.
Yes.
That's happened to me during one of my traveling abroad. At the airport, the immigration officer, out of curiosity, was asking me, "You are about which town?" I said, "Osusa." I said, "Osusa." I said, "Yes, the town of Leto Gunde." He said, "Ah, Gunde, ah." And he never asked any further questions, just turned my passport.
Wow.
So it's easier for me, and I like to always give that recognition to Osusa, being the town of Leto Gunde.
Wow.
My name is Oba Dr. Adetoye Akunmoji Arajeshi. You familiar with one, which is the title the town gave me.
Wow.
But traditionally, I'm the Ogunroyega the sixth.
Ogun what, sir?
Ogunroyega.
Ogunroyega the sixth.
Yes. Good. The big one of Osusa.
The big one of
Osusa.
Osusa. Now, Kabiesi, you have given your name to the whole world. Let's talk about your own opinion and view about Heritage TV, initiated by the Ministry of Culture and Tourism of the State, with the endorsement of His Excellency the Governor of the State, and having the Commissioner for Culture and Tourism as a driver. What can you say about this?
Well, I must say that it's not just that it's a new innovation. It's a welcome innovation. And we need to be, to give thanks to whom it is due. I am particularly happy that this initiative is by Honorable Commissioner, whom we joyfully call our paramount ruler, number five.
Number five.
When he was in the Ministry of Local Government and Chieftains Affairs, all of us in Ogun State, very, very glad, very, very happy. He was and he is still a very good gentleman, and he was liked by all. And so we joyfully gave him that accolade of paramount ruler. But this one, this baby, we are particularly happy about it because he has brought another innovation and he has continued to show to us that he is somebody that likes culture and tradition.
Wow.
And so when His Excellency put him in this ministry,
yeah,
we are particularly happy and we know that he will perform and he will do. Our prayers is that he will go places from there.
Wow.
That office will not be his limitation.
Wow.
That in the nearest future he will find himself in a higher office by the special grace of God.
Wow.
My perception of the Heritage TV is that it's going to go a long way in helping not just the Obasanjo, Ogun State, and Nigeria in general, because the world is such a small village now. It is the way we picture ourselves, the way we package our culture and tradition that the world will see. Okay? So I know that it's going to be a veritable tool. Okay? And I want to take this opportunity to tell some of our other royal fathers to embrace their child. To embrace, there's nothing to be afraid of when it comes to exposure. If you don't have skeletons in your cupboard, then I would say Heritage TV is a very good tool to let people know what you're doing. I am hoping that this will not be the end of our relationship, as what I've heard, part of the things that I know that your organization can do, I'm hoping that we will have a lot of other future endeavors together. God willing.
Thank you so much, Akagisi. As you can see now, that you cannot assume that the whole world is at your level. You need to check out other kingdoms to know whether what you are actually doing in your kingdom is in the right way. With Heritage TV, with Heritage Forum online, you can actually get connected with other real fathers. You can get frequent information. You can have instant communication, and especially when it comes to security issues. Online social media platform is a platform that has unlimited opportunities and unlimited benefits. What is going to limit you is your interest. Once you have interest and you are willing to take practical action, like our father here, the sky will just be the beginning. So, Kabisi, your activities on social media. Sometimes one could be curious because we know that majority of people we find on social media, especially on the Heritage Forum, they only read, they follow. What was your impression, your opinion when you first saw this group?
Well, my first impression was that this is another good forum for the others. First of all, the meetings are so far in between. Not only that, Obas are also, not all of us are members of the State Council of Government.
Wow.
As you know. And because our meetings are so far in between, we don't get to meet each other quite often.
Yes.
Then it is also an opportunity to tell other Alaeluas what is going on in your own domain. Some of the things that can be replicated somewhere else, particularly when it comes to encouraging culture and tradition.
Yes.
And also when it comes to industries. Because we all know that government cannot provide every opportunity, particularly for employment.
Yes.
You need for people to know how and what they can also do
yes.
in their own environment
yes.
to engender peace
yes.
and engender development.
Yes.
So for me, I am in other forums, as you probably know.
Wow.
But this is probably the best.
Wow.
And why I say that is that by the special grace of God today, I'm a number moving up for society. That is my primary assignment. That's my primary constituency. So for me, if there is a forum that I can just say something and the Omiko or the Ko in Badagri
yeah.
can take a cue and give me a reply immediately, whether in that moment or in another 1 hour or 2 hours, and can also make comments,
yes.
and others can also see it immediately,
yes.
I don't think there could be a better forum for that.
Thank you,
and I'm happy, and I'm saying this without missing word. We must congratulate the initiator of this program. Apart from the father, he's an excellent guy. But he could have just been doing his job. Others have been in that office before.
Yes.
But for bringing out this particular innovation, kudos to him.
Thank you so much, sir. Now, Kavis, one of the things that made some people believe in having on the Heritage Channel is that it gives them the opportunity to know more about various kingdoms. Now, how, let us look at, let's, you know, turn our searchlights to your kingdom, how you became the Oba, the big and the one. Were you drafted? Did you lobby for it? Were you the first?
No.
Were you once a prince? Or you were in exile? People want to know. The indigenous of this community and other communities want to know about the kingdom before now and now, sir.
I thank you very much again. I hope when you go around, your cameraman will be able to take a bit of pictures in the historic palace.
Wow.
Let me quickly tell you about the palace. This palace belongs to society.
Wow.
It is not my private residence.
Wow.
It is the community's palace. When I came in about 6 years ago, the first question was, where do we have a palace? I was living in my father's house. Living further down the road. That was the initial palace that I was living. But the community was so bigger, including myself and a few other notable citizens of this community, that we have a palace.
Wow.
And then we set out to build the palace, which was completed early last year.
Wow.
So, in the palace, we have pictures of at least the past four Obas.
Wow.
There are four ruling houses in Ososa. I am from Ogun area. There is Shombade,
okay.
There is Sheke,
okay.
And the fourth one is Laduba. Now, all the past four of us that their pictures are in the other hall are come from each ruling house. The last Ogun Ega was Ogun Ega fifth, late Albert. Olatunji Osowo is from my family.
Okay.
He lived for so long and his tenure was very, very remarkable.
Wow.
For those people will readily testify to that. And he died long ago, in 1956 to be precise.
Wow.
And it was not coincidental that a couple of months after his death, I was born.
Wow.
So, his, let me say, prediction or his position there from history was that not until another overcome from his family would they begin to see serious development in us. That's what I was told by the elderly people. Coincidentally, he was also the last of us that lived in the palace, used by the community. And that was on this spot where we are.
Okay.
But no sooner he died, the place became derelict. It was a mud house, and it went the way the mud houses used to go when they are camp. Such that the whole of this place was virtually a dump site.
Wow.
They left a few spaces in front there for transport, you know, this Marwa and when I came, I asked the elderly people, where was the palace? And they said, oh, it's a small place, you cannot hold anything. I said, let us go and see the place. Even if it is just 2 rooms, we will first start that room. And then we begin to look for a bigger place. I must tell you that the last Oba before me, the late Onoyinka, a very good erudite scholar, first-class citizen, had plans to build the palace. And a site was earmarked. But when I came, I went to look at the place. And for whatever reason, my personal intuition just told me, no, this cannot be the palace. I went back alone in the night, alone, when there was nobody with me. Still, my aura did not tell me that is where the palace is. So the following day, I asked the elderly people, where was the former palace? And they pointed to this point. And I insisted that this is where the palace is going. So we pledged this for you. tons and tons of debris were removed from this place. And then we took a survey, we measured the land, we drew the plans, and we started. We started with the United Society,
wow,
Lagos, ably led then by one Baba Chief G.F. Okusan, another notable citizen. We started the foundation, and then the rest is history. It was built by the contribution of all sorts of people. Some who are not even sons and daughters of the society, just because we had a relationship or we spoke with them. Some just came and saw that, we are doing a good thing here. Here is my own widow's man.
Right.
Including even government,
wow,
including local government, and including the state government. Mm-hmm. Everybody participated in building this palace. Wow. And there is a history, there's a gold plate wall there,
okay,
with names written in gold. Those are people who are giving us donations above 100,000.
Okay.
Anyway, we built the palace, and then the hall that you saw across there,
yeah,
was principally completed by the Baba Oba Officers. That's not Baba Oba, Chief Ayo Ogunde, the son of the late Bati Gunde. His massive contribution was what we used to complete the hall. That's why we named that hall Ogunde Hall.
Okay.
But the fact is that getting here was not just by accident. I think it was predetermined, predestined. Let me put it like that. When the late Onoyinka died, naturally there were mutations that since our family left,
okay,
and all that. Okay. And people were just running around. I was at that time working in government.
Okay.
At the state level, I was in primary health.
Okay.
I was the pioneer executive secretary of primary health care development agency. So we had meetings in the family. We had a brother that was very much interested, a retired engineer from Air Force. Mr. Fatayat. So the whole family supported him. And he had been coming here to meet the kingmakers, and I was just doing my job. I was not particularly interested in upper-ship.
Wow.
I remember that one of the kingmakers then came around to talk to me and said, actually, it wasn't me, he came to see my mother. I came home that weekend, so he came to see my late mother. And I said, what is this, Baba Lulu? This cabbage is shit. I said, well, I don't have time. You go and look for one of your sons in the village. To cut the story short, news began to flow back that by divination, by oracle, divination, okay, and all that, our brother was not qualified,
okay,
or was not particularly favored,
okay,
by the gods. I don't know what they meant. So they came back to the family. Then we just have to provide somebody.
Wow.
And this was long after our deadline had expired. Because we had a family meeting where we said anybody that is interested should write a letter of intention. I think 1 December 26 or one particular year, I forgot. But long after that, they came back. And so I was approached by my siblings, both Sima and Juna, and said, me, no, it's not good. Then they put pressure. My wife, Olori, was part of the pressure.
Wow.
So one day, I think I came home from Abeokuta, and she told me that she saw my late friend. I can't use my late friend. He said that he knows I'm afraid, but that he should tell me to go and accept. I said, hey, so you two are one of the conspirators. But you see, immediately I quickly remember that my wife was not given to such frivolous.
Wow.
And she had never said that to me ever in our life together as husband and wife. So I began to take her serious. And naturally, I also went around and made some consultation.
Findings.
Yes. Consultations, particularly with our royal father, at the Royal Majesty of our security commander. And he said, well, you know, he's fond of calling me Pama. Pama was my political minister.
Okay. Look,
if your people want you, you better just go and accept. Because you need to go around and see all the notable personalities in Mosesa, including Chief Rajesh Adegwa, and a number of other notable people. Uluyo Moba, Mojin Yamzat, and some other senior citizens of the town. So we started going around and consulting. And everybody was like, oh, yeah, I do as Japan, and you know, and all that. And that was how my candidature was accepted, endorsed, and it just went like a whirlwind.
Wow.
No rancor, nothing.
Wow.
And that's how I found myself.
Thank you so much, sir. I can see you've practically taken over this session for me. And I think there's nothing that can be as original like original itself. So you've spoken from the heart, and we also want to bring our attention to when you attained this position, sir. How has it been?
Well, what can I say? 6 years now, and I'm still pinching myself.
Yeah,
I'm pinching myself because I also find it difficult to believe that you have achieved what you have done in 6 years.
Wow.
I find it difficult to believe because it just went like yesterday.
Wow.
It seemed like 24 hours was not even enough on the daily basis. But we must thank God. When we came, Osusa was practically a quiet town. Practically very quiet. But I must say that I was just here at the right time.
Yes.
Not that most of the achievements were by my power, but I think by the special grace of God. A number of things have happened in Osusa, development here and there, a number of sons and daughters have also come back to contribute. Things that were not either available or happening in Osusa. And I must give credence to all these fellows because starting from the big industry right across the road,
okay.
As you can see that rice food that is brought here by Elijah Dubois, who used to be a Lagos businessman.
Yeah.
Then it was during my time that he thought he was going to come back to Osusa and settle down.
Wow.
We have people like Chief Mrs. Oladipo who has come to construct a housing estate, a big hall for event center. We have a number of other people like that. Some have brought back their industry, the block industry and all that. We have big time companies already even showing interest in coming to settle in this. Right across the express again, that's where we have a Econ Petrol industry. They want to do a factory for making blue.
Okay.
In fact, they have started already making their oil somewhere, I don't know, but if you buy the oil of Econ today, engine oil of Econ, you will see they're made in Osusa.
Wow.
They've just acquired the land, and I think they are waiting for approval from His Excellency. Maybe I should use this opportunity to ask His Excellency to grant the approval so that they can continue. So many things have gone. On my own personal contribution, as a health practitioner, you know I'm a medical doctor.
Wow.
My first love is my practice. So again, when I came into the town, first place I went was the health center.
Yeah.
I was interested in that center because I knew when it was upgraded by the last government. So I went there and we started talking with the people that for this place to move, you need to have a doctor.
Yes.
And for a doctor to come to a rural area, you must have a comfortable residence.
Yes.
So the first thing I did was I single-handedly built a doctor's quarter.
Okay.
A very modern doctor's quarter. Went to NYC in Shagamu, spoke with them, and they were interested. They posted the doctor to us, and the place started moving.
Wow.
I soon discovered again that nurses who have been posted from government institutions or even private health institutions like OG were sleeping in the wards meant for patients.
Wow.
Sometimes I get called out there in the middle of the night. I go there to help them. with a retained second twin, retained placenta. I was working there practically like a medical officer. So I came there in the morning, I discovered nurses were coming out from the patient's room. I said, what? They said, they don't have a place to stay. Wow. Again, I built a two-room nurses' quarter in that health center. It's there for me.
Wow.
We are so happy with the status that are right. But that is not even enough. Presently, we are looking at putting in a surgical department because we found out that people are still going to the Bode, Shagamu, for little surgeries that we can do by ourselves, like aneurysm, cesarean section. I'm happy we've gotten the approval of the local government doctor that I should go and take a look at the place. If I find a suitable place, we will convert it into a small surgery.
Wow.
So, majorly, my number one love is anything that has to do with health and education.
Wow.
When we came, the results of our secondary school levels were very, very poor. But I can tell you in the past 3 years, it has improved gradually to such a level that the last white result was really something to be proud
of. I will not allow you to turn me into a spectator.
Ah.
You will not, sir. So, you can see that we have a KBAC that is loaded, a KBAC that is welcoming, a KBAC that is ready to follow you and to be followed on social media. Now, KBAC, let's look at the your kingdom, your environment, by category. How many barriers? How many communities?
Oh, that's true. You probably also find that in our history. I am giving you a document on the history of Osusa. Osusa is renowned to be a town of seven quarters. So in Yoruba we call it Ilu Olushi Meje. Yes, we have predominantly seven quarters. We have other quarters, but predominantly seven quarters. As the town is getting bigger, and this is the thing I was telling my chief, that as the town is getting bigger, the earlier we begin to embrace all the other chiefs.
Yes.
Because what we are doing now here is not secret cause.
Mm-hmm.
And the more the merrier. For the ease of governance, it's better when we all sit down and the information is passed to all once and for all.
Wow.
But we are very proud of our seven quarters. And it's made up of Okeala, Ijoku, Okeasin, Odualeri, Odua, Domowo, and which one is the seventh one? I've mentioned Odua, Domowo, Odualeri, Osalakwe. Yes, Osalakwe. Where we have a new chief recently installed. So, those are the seven predominant quarters. And we have what we call traditional council meetings, where I chair the meeting, where we discuss some of the things that is happening in our community. But more importantly is that the big one there is the prescribing authority over this area. And our people are very much in concern with that. We have the anthem. We have an anthem that signifies the position of the society and all that it takes. But what I'm particularly happy about is that administration haven't been on like that before. Yeah. We have also elevated it to a level where in the nearest future all these potatoes can be fully recognized by God.
As
probably violent, because we need to take it to that level. And as the town continues to grow, so the custom will also expand.
Accommodate them. Wow, that is wonderful. A lot of people might not know about this. Kamiyesi, I strongly want to believe that with your meeting with the Heritage TV now, we are going to be receiving a lot of pictures of sight and sound of your community uploaded by you through a call, sir.
No, definitely. We'll continue to do that. Not just because we want people to be aware, but we want it to be in history.
Wow.
You see, as you rightly mentioned earlier on in our preamble, even though I'm not too sure that has been confirmed, but when you said history is no longer going to be taught in the school. I can't say that I've not had that one, but I still believe that maybe that decision will be rescinded. History is very, very important.
Very, very important.
People say if you don't know where we are going, at least you know where we are coming from. And for the black race, particularly, the Yoruba, we cannot afford not to teach history. We cannot afford to let our children know. I am moved, particularly when I meet Yoruba couple, or Igbo couple for that matter. Now let's limit it to Yoruba couple. Whose children are not speak Yoruba. I am perturbed by their attitude, and I tell them, look, what the hell are you trying to do? If you cannot encourage your children to speak Yoruba now, then you are going to pay, or they will invariably pay, to learn a language that they will have learned for free from their birth.
And so I want to
encourage our people that our language is better.
Wow.
You don't necessarily have to be a chief or a nobler before you know that your children will speak Yoruba.
Wow.
Every time I travel abroad and I meet our people, I encourage them and I tell them. Part of the reason why a number of our graduates in the diaspora are not getting married to Nigerians now is because they've changed their attitude. Their children don't even feel that they are Nigerian. And it's really pity. So unless we begin to make sure that we encourage such an endeavor like yours, and I know that this is not going to be your limitation. I mean, this you will not limit it to just interviewing
Dr. Fabat.
We are going to be talking about language.
Yes, sir.
We are going to probably...
Even right here, we are going to speak in the Igbo language. Where I can see you,
We are going to also expect language sessions on your TV.
Wow.
Where children in classes, for the ease of the teacher, can log on to your heritage at a particular time of the day, and Yoruba language can be taught.
And that makes you think it is, according to you saying, your heritage, or it should be our heritage TV?
No, our heritage is good. If you leave the, if you leave us open to buy into stocks in your, I mean the shares of your company, we will gladly do so.
Wow,
but because it's your organization right now, we must encourage you.
Thank you, sir.
We must encourage you. But obviously, it is something that I'm personally very, very elated about.
Thank you so much, sir. Now, Kabiyesi, one of the things that brings the indigenes of a particular community or town back or spread their news is festivals,
yes,
activities. I'm quite sure that within your domain, can you share with us notable festivals? Like we have a video bar, we have all kinds of festivals everywhere. I think
the most important festival in our society, for your sons and daughters, is Ogun Ibe.
Ige.
Yes, that is the real Ogun of their upper.
Okay.
Usually in the early part of the new year, usually in January, when the upper celebrate his annual festival.
Okay.
Because of the importance of that festival, all sons and daughters are encouraged to come. During that festival, the Bigonde dance sees thrice.
Wow.
We go to dance early in the morning.
Okay.
We come back with take breakfast.
Okay.
We go and dance in the afternoon, come back with take lunch.
Okay.
Then we dance also in the evening. Then we entertain everybody.
Wow.
This is a festival that I always look up to.
Wow.
Because it gives me opportunity to invite fellow of us to come and.
Wow.
The last one we had that, we even had regents from far away in Accra who came to celebrate with us. Beyond that, we have a Gungun festival.
Wow.
We have Ogudoba, we copied it from the Ogudoba.
Wow.
I will be the first person to readily admit that. And because all the Ogudobas are very proud of Ogudoba, our sons and daughters also felt that we should be celebrating something here.
Yeah.
Because the regular tradition has also caught up with our people here who are not big enough to show their openness the way it is done in the body. But we thank God. So in Osanya, we have, for the respect of our father, Royal Majesty, Kabujan of Jabuna, shifted our Yudoba to the second day after our doom, rather than the third day. So the second day, immediately after Ogunleya, we will do our own Yudoba. So that the following day, everybody wants to go to Yudoba. You know, Osanya is already just a suburb of Jabuna.
Of course, of course.
We allow our children also to go up and decide that I'm a bona fide member of the age group of the Bobakere.
Oh,
number one foremost regular in the public.
Wow.
So I'm always glad to be able to go and join my colleagues on the Yudoba Day to do our normal homage to His Royal Majesty. Then we have that, you know, statue, like I said. We have a Gugu festival, like I said. We have other festivals, but one tradition is the one you met this morning.
Okay.
The every 5 days, divination at the shrine.
Okay.
So it's unique for that.
Okay.
I am not aware of any community where that is done.
Okay.
If they used to do it, they probably have not encouraged it.
Yeah.
Since I became Bigone, it has always been to the practice. This movement we call them Otumba Bigone. They will go to the shrine every five days to do divination, find out from the oracle what is going to happen, what do we need to do, and pray particularly for peace and love. And I wait back here every 5 days to receive them.
Wow.
The only time they will not go is if it's raining heavily.
Okay.
And if the day falls on a Sunday.
Okay.
So that those of them who are Christian can afford to go to church.
That's wonderful. It's been a nice time with our Royal Father. I think this is not the end. We are going to continue the discussion on the social media because I know that a lot of you out there will want to have a follow-up question. And I'm very much sure that our Father will be more than happy to provide answers to all your requests.
Yes. And to know the time you are talking about. That's happened to me during one of my traveling abroad. At the airport, the immigration officer, out of curiosity, was asking me, "You are Oba of which town?" I said, "Ososa." I said, "Ososa?" I said, "Yes, the town of Late Ogunde." He said, "Ah, Ogunde, ah!" And he never asked any further questions. Just stand my passport.
Wow.
So it's easier for me, and I like to always give that recognition to Ososa, being the town of Ogunde. My name is Oba Dr. Adetoye Akunmoji Arateshi, from Noyewan, which is the title the town gave me.
Wow.
But traditionally, I'm the Ogunroyega the sixth.
Ogunwata.
Ogunroyega. Ogunroyega, first of all, is the thing. It is the quickest way to get to know everybody. And because everybody claims now that the world is a global village, there's no way I'm not going to be part of it. Not just me, but my community also. So I'm glad to be on social media because it is a very small world. And we need to project what we are doing for our people, particularly those of them in the diaspora.
Thank you so much, KBSC. Now, you can see a nice intro. If I had told you that my KBSC is a social media KBSC, it could be like packaging. You've heard from him from the intro. KBSC, can we start from knowing you? We want to know you. We want the whole world to know where we are. You know, I didn't say where we are. So we want the whole world to know where we are. Royega the sixth.
Good. The big one day of Ososa.
The big one day of
Ososa.
Ososa. Now, KBSC, you have given your name to the whole world. Let's talk about your own opinion and view about LJTV. Initiated by the Ministry of Culture and Tourism of the state with the endorsement of His Excellency the Governor of the state and having the Commissioner for Culture and Tourism as a driver. What can you say about this?
Well, I must say that it's not just that it's a new innovation. It's a welcome innovation. And we need to be to give thanks to whom it is due.
Over to you, sir.
Are you ready? Are you sure you are ready?
Yes.
We thank God. First of all, we need to thank God for saving our life. we've been following the successes of Heritage. And we're particularly happy to be associated with it. And most welcome to the Osusa Kingdom.
Thank you, sir.
I always like to have the fact that it is a town of late to Ogunde, because Ogunde brought Osusa into the international limelight long ago. As the doyen of Nigerian theater has, it is easier for anybody in the whole world to know.
Wherever you are watching from any part of the world, it is good to know that you are following our cultural trend. I am not the custodian, but I'm here, I'm standing, and I'm sitting on the rock of the custodian of African culture and heritage. And I wouldn't want to say further until I allow my host to introduce and to set the ball rolling. Kabisi. It is nice and good to meet with you, and I think the whole world is already in conversation with your action. Kabisi, you are one of the Kabisis that are on social media doing what are you doing here, sir?
What social media?